As arable farmers, we either accept the pricing or don't grow the crop. If we don't agree to the price that we're offered, that company overseas will get it produced somewhere else. If we were to still have the same yields that we did 20 years ago, there'd be no arable farmers left in Canterbury. The only way that we're able to survive is with productivity gains and getting smarter in the way that we do things. We are Gary and Rae Wilson, mixed arable farmers from Hines. My farming operations encompass two blocks, about 300 odd hectares. We grow carrots for seed production, radish, ryegrass for seed, maize for silage, and anything else that's profitable. I grew up in Hines when primarily we were all sheep farmers with a little bit of crop. Now it's predominantly dairying. The prices we're receiving for our product are probably on a par with what we received 25 years ago. That's why Mid Canterbury has converted so much to dairying. The dollars and cents mean that they have to change. So the only way we've been able to survive is increase our production with better use of water, better timing and application of the fertiliser, using soil sampling across the farm so that we can put the nutrients where they're needed, always upgrading and just trying to be smarter about the way we farm. All of the technology and environmental outcomes that we are trying to achieve with water, with fertiliser, with keeping our waterways clean and green, all comes at a huge cost. The only way we can achieve that is if our farms are profitable. If our farms aren't profitable, we don't have any money to have the environmental outcomes that we would like. The consumer does have a big part to play. When someone goes shopping in the supermarket for bread, they usually go to the cheapest variety, and quite often that's from imported product. It would be nice if they could think of New Zealand producers and buy something that's New Zealand produced and New Zealand grown.